And in business, at the close of the MPC meeting, which held at the Apex Bank in Abuja, the CBN Governor Godwin Emefiele announced a decision to leave all parameters the same, as they also adjusted policies to curb the effect of the COVID-19 on the economy. Joining me via phone is Ayo Teriba, who is the CEO at Economic Associates. Thank you for joining me, Ayo. The CBN decided to leave the parameters the same after the MPC meeting yesterday. What's your take on this?
For the MPC meeting to be potent, for them to have the autonomy to use their instrument, one fundamental that must be in place, one macroeconomic fundamental or policy fundamental, is that there must be external reserve adequacy. You must have adequate level of foreign reserves to meet short-term trade and capital flow obligations. When you don't have that, the risk is if you ease monetary policy as you currently need to, that ease is going to spill over into excess demand in the foreign exchange market. And since we don't have adequate reserves to cover the increase in demand, then it can't ease. Unfortunately, this is one of the weakest moments for the Central Bank of Nigeria, that oil price has dropped as low as around $30 a barrel, and that doesn't put the reserves in a good situation. So our reserves are likely to deplete than accrue.
All right, we also know that international organizations are pumping in a lot of money to ensure that this pandemic is over. However, what measures would you suggest that or expect that the government would execute post the lockdown?
One positive aspect to this lockdown is that, yes, it has obstructed trade, foreign trade. It has obstructed exports, obstructed imports. You can't even sell. Demand has collapsed. Stores are now empty. That's the downside of it. But the upside of it is that the richest countries in the world are throwing money at the problem. Mm-hmm. So as people are in a lockdown, you know, America is putting a package together, including proposals to give each American $1,000 to give this sector money, give that sector money. At the end of the day, when the lockdown is lifted, you had a global financial system that already had a liquidity glut, that interest rates were already negative in some parts of the world. And now these big liquidity injections meant to fight the coronavirus pandemic, meant to provide ease for people who can't go to work, who can't earn income, we increase even that glut of liquidity. So any country, any developing country that knows what they are doing, if they adopt the right strategies shortly after the end of the lockdown, they will attract record levels of capital inflow that will even be bigger than what we have lost from the falling oil price, or what we have lost from being unable to trade or being unable to do business because of the lockdown.
All right, thank you very much. That was Ayo Teriba on the line, the CEO of Economic Associates.